In this video, we will see the energetics of muscle contraction. Or, in simple words, we will see from where the energy comes and where exactly it is used during a muscle contraction. Needless to say, the medium to transfer the energy is ATP. So our discussion is basically about the generation and expenditure of ATPs. First, let's see where the ATPs are consumed. Most of the ATPs are consumed in the myosin crossbridge cycle, during which the actin filaments are pulled over myosin filaments. Apart from that, some ATPs are consumed in pumping calcium into the sarcoplasmic reticulum after contraction is over. And some are used by the sodium-potassium ATPase pump to restore the ionic balance after an action potential, similar to other cells in the body. So these are the processes that consume ATPs during a muscle contraction. Now let's see where these ATPs come from. The immediate source is the ready-made pull of the ATPs. However, this quantity is small, and it lasts for only about 1 to 2 seconds during a full muscle contraction. As energy from these ATPs is used, they get converted to ADPs. To continue the supply of energy, the ATP needs to be regenerated from these ADPs. There are three sources for this. The first source is phosphocreatine. It acts as a temporary energy buffer. It carries a high-energy phosphate. By the enzyme creatine kinase, this phosphate is transferred to ADP, thus forming ATP. However, the quantity of phosphocreatine is also limited, and it can generate ATPs only for additional 4 to 6 seconds. The second source of energy is the glycolysis of glycogen. Glycogen is already stored in muscle cells. Its rapid breakdown into pyruvic acid and lactic acid liberates energy, which is used to synthesize ATPs. There are two plus points with this source. First, it can occur without oxygen, so it can supply ATPs even when enough oxygen is not being delivered to the muscle. And second, it's very fast. It's 2.5 times faster than the oxidative mechanism that we will see next in generating ATPs. So these are the advantages of glycolysis. It can sustain maximum muscle contraction for up to 1 minute, but eventually the accumulation of so many end products of glycolysis makes it incapable of supplying ATPs any further. And that's where third and the ultimate source of energy comes in. It's oxidative phosphorylation. Oxidative metabolism of carbohydrates, fats, and even proteins releases energy that is used to regenerate ATPs from ADPs. It lasts as long as the muscle gets the supply of these energy sources and oxygen. During a long-term muscle contraction, more than 95% of ATPs are supplied this way. So, these were all the sources of ATPs. Now let's have a quick summary. The immediate source of energy for muscle contraction is ATPs already available in the cell. It lasts for 1 to 2 seconds only. The first source for ATP generation is phosphocreatine, which lasts for additional 4 to 6 seconds. The second source is the glycolysis of glycogen, and it lasts for up to 1 minute. The third and final source is the oxidative metabolism of carbohydrates, fats, or proteins. It lasts for long term. The ATPs are consumed mainly in the mechanical work of pulling actin over myosin, and small quantity is used to transport calcium into the sarcoplasmic reticulum and to transport sodium and potassium across the cell membrane. That's it for this video. Click here to read the notes on this video at our website. You can also explore our entire physiology animation video library over there. To support my free content creation, first leave a nice comment and then share the video with all your friends and colleagues. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.